day. We're going to the pool. We talked about it yesterday and decided today we're gonna go. So here we go. And I think this is the first time you see me brunette. I don't know. Anyways, there's just a pool in the apartment complex. And we used to go at night because I work night shift. And it was really chill. We would get to sit in the hot tub. Yeah, it was just really chill. And then all of a sudden, Hunter and I went up there and the fucking thing was locked. But there was a guy inside the pool area and he was like, oh, hang on, dude, I'll open it for you. He looked legit. And he tries opening it from the inside. He couldn't get the door open either. And so I'm sitting there going through my mail because the mailboxes are by the pool. And a security guard, like he's dressed as a security guard, comes up and he's like, hey, is there anybody in there? And I'm like, well, yeah, there's like a dude in there. And so he's like, yeah, I locked it, blah, blah, blah. So anyways, they're locking the pool at night. I don't know why. I don't know what the situation is. Anyways, we live the furthest from the pool that you can live. We're like in the very, very, very last apartment. So that's why I'm getting in my car. So yeah. And I left my sunglasses in here, so I hope they don't burn me. The only thing I have on, is I have Sugar Fresh and Petal on my lips. So we really never went to the pool during the day. And I asked Hunter, I can remember going to taking him to the pool when I was, when he was little, actually, and I would take my iPod. You'll see. See how long it'll take me to get up there. That's how far we live. And I always have my iPod. So I asked Hunter today, I was like, oh, do you have this extra set of headphones? He says no. Like, oh my God, what am I going to do? But I brought my book. I got the book Holly Madison Down the Rabbit Hole, and I was really like hyped to read it, but I haven't started it yet, so I figured today is a good day. I am wearing a two-piece today, and I really don't care. I really don't care. Thanks. And at first I was nervous. Like normally I always wear two piece. Like always. Like you will never see me in a one piece. Like even at the water park. I was like, oh my God, what if there's all these skinny California girls? And I debated. And then I was like, you know what? No, we are going. I am going. I shouldn't be that self-conscious or whatever. So, we are like finally almost at the beginning of the apartment complex by the pool. And there's only one pool here. And it's like, this apartment complex is huge. Like, I don't even know. Like, we're in building Q. Better not give me a fine. So I'm probably like violating laws and all kinds of shit. But I don't know. I Alright, and I know there's mail for me at the post office, so... I'm not at the post office, inside the office. So we're going to go in there. I'm going to let Hunter have the keys, get the regular mail, and yeah. And I'm going to go in and see what's in the office, okay? Hang on, because I got to hold this. Just lock my door when we get out. Hi. I think there's mail for Q1504. I got a hula hoop in the mouth. Help, I'm locked out. My child. So my child comes bearing gifts, which means I'm gonna have to put them in my car. Maybe not. Okay, come on. Thank you, Hunt. There's a lady behind you, Hunt. So that's a business center. So this should be a new hoop. I left my practice hoops in Houston because they weren't collapsible. I mean, I bought it off my first hoop teacher, Heidi, and they weren't collapsible, so I pretty much, like, I couldn't take them in my car. I'm gonna use my key like a knife. So, I had to order a new hoop on Etsy, and this one's collapsible. Because, I don't know, like, Hunter, like, I mean, he's my child, I love him, of course, but, like, no matter what I do, he wants to argue about, like, he wants, you know, it's like Disney passes, they're not enough, he wants to argue about Disney, going to the pool, he wants to go, he's the one that wanted to go, and then he gets here, and then he just sits over there, so... I don't know what to do with my child. Okay. taking forever. So I got this amazingly gorgeous hoe, and I can't get it to uncollapse. So I watched your video before I left the house today, as I knew it was coming in the mail. And then here she goes. It's dancehoops.com or dancehoops.etsy.com. And it's in Clements, California. So she's right here in California. It came within a week. It was really quick. Opening up your colossal hoop. So, I mean, she's got the instructions. So we're gonna try to get something going. In my water, I just have blueberry, lemon, and cucumber. And then I've got an alkalizer stick. I don't know, everyone's always like tripped out about what that is. At the pool, reading my book. I'm on like chapter 5. This is so good, I don't even want to put it down. I love it. Are you ready to go home? Yeah? Okay. You can pan around and show the whole pool. Just show the camera. And you can film me from the back. I got from Forever 21 a few years ago. So, actually, and then my sandals, they're also from like 3 or 4 years old. And they're Roxy. They're brown. I don't know, they don't match my bathing suit, but they're the quickest things I have. And then, here's my new baby. I finally put her together. Sorry about that. So I just checked and apparently they came in the mail, so I'm just gonna go check the mail and get them. But I have to park like illegally in someone's parking spot, so I mean, not illegally, because, like, technically, I mean, I'm not going to get a ticket, but someone could get technically pissed off. No fucks given at all. So this is like travel nurse apartment living mailbox hell. It looks like there is an ice cream social, which I think I have to work. So I don't know. What did I get? Time Warner cable, and then I got my things. So I think my phone just made a noise. I wonder if my husband called. Okay, so let's check these out. I'm kind of excited. Because it's always hard, you know what I mean? Like, you tell little kids, you're like, is it a smiley face? Is it just a regular face? Is it like a crying face? You know, and they never know how to rate it. So, yeah. Here, this is so cool. So, I mean, see how like there's the different faces, and then you tell the kids the points of the face. Like, how does it hurt, you know? Does it hurt like you're crying, or does it hurt like the middle, or are you happy, or what? And so then, you know, they can rate their pain on that scale. That is so cool. Another one is frequently in the ER, especially like in triage, they use a pregnancy wheel, but this is not in wheel form. It's in card form that goes on my badge. And so you can tell from someone to the first day of someone's last period when their due date is if they're pregnant. So I thought that was kind of cool. Yeah, so we're gonna add that to the badge. Actually, this is like a pen light that I got from Memorial Children's Hospital. They came and picked up a kid in our ER, I think last week. But yeah. Oh, I almost lost it too. Yeah, it always sucks when we have bad babies and they have to get transferred to a children's hospital. Alright, so this will be boring, but I'll catch up with you at the tanning salon.
I it's funny to be.
I'm about to sign you up and scan it every time you walk.
I have a 5-star. I have a 5-star.
Oh, okay. What else did she tell you?
So this is the high pressure bed. I think it's still 12 minutes. I'm like trying to get undressed without being on camera. So, I'm outside of my apartment. I'm sitting on the stairs. I don't know. It goes, like, to my upstairs neighbor's apartment. I'm on the bottom floor. But I figured this is where I would cut off this blog, this vlog. Let's see. I've been out here 3 months. And I'm gonna be here another 3 months. At least I'm supposed to be. I'm supposed to be here till actually October 31st. And I'm homesick. I don't know, years ago, I mean, when my son was a lot younger, I did travel nursing and it was like, it was no biggie, you know what I mean? It was like great. And I loved it. And I've traveled to California before several times. I've been to several different cities out here and it's always been really cool. However, this hospital, I don't know, there's like a mean girls club and I don't fit in with the mean girls club. I don't know if you could tell that or not, but I'm just not that type. And the Mean Girls Club didn't even start till after I was there. There was a couple new travelers that came in and they joined up. There's only like 3 staff nurses, so they joined this one staff nurse. Anyways, I'm homesick. I pretty much am taking my life day by day. I have today off. I worked last night, I worked tomorrow night, so I have one day off in between, so like I should have been sleeping all day, but I didn't really. I don't even know how to explain it. So I'm taking life day by day. I don't know. I was almost in tears last night. I mean, I don't know how to tell you the stories because I don't want to breach any patient confidentiality. I don't want to give my hospital away or anything. Just know, as an ER nurse, I feel for you. I feel for you when you're waiting in the waiting room and you're in pain and you're sick. I feel for your mom and your dad and your grandma and your brother and your sister and your kids when you guys are in the waiting room. And I wish I could help you and I wish I had more control, but I don't. And as the nurse, I cannot practice medicine. I am bound by what the doctor tells me I can do and give you. Just know that I am a true patient advocate and I am here for you, and that's why I'm a nurse. I go to areas where there's a severe critical nursing shortage and they basically can't run their department unless they brought people like me in. I mean, they would have to close. So it's people like me that help keep patients safe, help keep patients alive, help keep things going. I mean, I've been an ER nurse for a long time, so I can go anywhere and just walk in and do what I need to do. But it's really, I don't know, disheartening. I'm going to end this now. And until my next vlog, maybe I'll be in California. All right. Bye, guys.